We finally did it. We have made it to the end of the album. It is time for outro, which kind of should have been an intro from what people are telling me in the comments. From what you guys have told me, I should have done outro before doing intro 3. Instead, we went with the noob order, i.e. just the standard order, not realizing that that's not the order that Nate originally released it in. We're making up for it. We're back. We're here. It is time for outro, and I am so ready for it. It is finally time. I've journeyed through an entire album to get to this moment. The amount of times you guys have talked to me about how good this is, I'm ready for it. Outro is finally here. Let's go. By the way, my name's Kieran, aka Pastor Scar. Yes, I'm a pastor. Yes, I'm a musician. Yes, I have a stream room. Yes, I have Bulbasaur. And yes, I believe that you are loved, valued, and worthy of knowing how much you matter. Cool? Let's go. Here we go. No! No, 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 no. Can I pause already? You know, right? Or are you just finding this video for the first time and you didn't do the journey with me? Because if you didn't do the journey with me, pause right now, hit the playlist button, go back to the start, and go from there. Because as soon as I saw Nate wrapped in caution tape, I realized what... Oh, ladies and gentlemen, there is a song called Intro, like the first intro, like the intro of the intros, where our friend Nate, a lot younger at the time, was wrapped in caution tape looking just about like that. Now we are up to outro. So outro is making a reference to intro. The difference is that 3 albums have happened in that time. Oh, I believe we're about to go on an emotional journey. Please tell me this is like a recap of all recaps. I need this in my life. Let's go. What does the TV say? I can't read it. It's too blurry. And I had to look sideways. But that's right. We'll figure it out. If you know, let me know in the comments down below. I'm sure it's a reference to something. Maybe even intro. Let's go. There's the chairs. Mailbox.
Dedicated. The definition of dedication.
That house looked familiar behind him. He's also wearing the hat that says real on it. Some of his merch. All right, we're going back. There's going to be so much to break down in this video. I'm so excited. Let's go.
Dedicated. The definition of dedication. Wrote this old record while I was levitating. Sitting in my room with the pen and paper. I'm innovative. They've been afraid of me since I was a second grader. I'm the kid on the playground. Mama told you to never play, but there's levels of music.
No way. He's doing it. He's doing it. He's literally going through. Like, this is a time, like, go watch the playlist. You need to do this. You need to watch those and come back and watch this. Because there is a song. Oh, why can't I remember it? Why can't I remember what it's called? I can't remember what it's called. But I remember the video clip so vividly because there's the car accident. And, like, do they even get the same actor? Is she the same lady from it? Did they keep the props from that video clip the whole time just to make this? Did he plan that far ahead? Probably, knowing this man, lyrical genius. But oh my word. Let me know in the comments down below. What song is that? I know it's in the playlist, so I can go back and watch. And I will. But you should too. Help us out. Thank you. Love you.
Me since I was a second grader. I'm the kid on the playground. Mama told you to never play, but there's levels of music and I'm in the elevator, going up to the top floor. Look how we elevated. But you don't know the brand by now. You better get educated. Take both of my...
You don't know the brand right now, you better get educated. I love that. It's true, though. By this point, get educated. And you know the irony of it? I didn't know NF until many, many years after this point. So I was one. I'm speaking to myself here. I was one of those that needed to get educated. I only found out about NF because of one of our mods on Twitch, a guy that you guys know and love named Toby or TB Thunder or all kinds of different versions of his name. He's probably going to leave a comment down below. We love Toby. He's the guy that edits these videos and this whole series was his idea. Because of Tobes, I now know of NF. And as Toby's birthday present, I'm taking him to the NF concert. And my wife and I are going to literally fly to another state just to go with him. How cool is that? Anyway, I was one of those noobs. Let's play on.
My arms, rip on my sockets, separate them. Forgive me, yeah, I know I get animated. Don't matter, I still write a better record than yours without a hesitation. Never been more motivated. Just look at all the minds I have opened and penetrated. See, I am the voice of all these kids that think things but never say them. That's why they come to my shows wearing the NF hoodies and hats low like we're carrying weapons. Put the controllers away, it's game over. I promise I'm way colder to
Dude, this song is so good. The background, like everything about it. Everything about it. Visually, it is super stimulating because I'm seeing all of these little Easter eggs. Like, old mate with the rake, I'm like, I've seen you before. The house behind, I've seen it before. Where have I seen it? I don't know anymore. It's all blurring together. Let me know down below, please. But, like, this is so exciting. Also, musically and lyrically, this is brilliant. As a gamer myself, I appreciate the games over the controller reference. Like, let's go. That's us. He shouted us out. but... Oh, the crescendo, the build-up, the way that you can feel the bass in your chest. Man, does he do this song live? I hope so, because so far I'm liking it.
Put the controllers away, it's game over. I promise I'm way colder. The fans keep saying that they're hungry for new music. Well, that's pretty convenient, because I just made a plate for them. And now
I don't hear none of y'all. I love that lyric. The fans are hungry for new music. Well, that's pretty convenient. I just made a plate for them. He's like, eat up. Eat up, and man, we will. Absolutely.
The
ambulance as well. They're all, like, stuck in this freeze frame, right? Like they haven't actually frozen the frame. They've got the actors there, but they're all just, like, watching. So it's kind of like he's having this out-of-body experience, reflecting on all of these different songs from the past, which, as you know, a lot of his songs are talking about parts of his past. Maybe not literally, sometimes figuratively, but regardless, it's his journey. And here he is kind of retrospectively looking at his own journey and summing it up like you would in an outro, but doing it in a way that we can reflect along with him. It's just so good.
If you've been waiting, the wait's over. You ain't noticed y'all about to witness the takeover. Yeah,
I remember that one.
I need a match, emotion that I had in the last one.
The kid.
Don't they gonna tell me that I'm losing my...
Is that the kid? The kid who was self-harming? I think it might have been. That was a full-on video, man. So many of these are. Like, you see the domestic violence situation going on in the background there as well. Like, you... Whoo! This is an emotional... This is an emotional one, man.
They're waiting on me to match the emotion that I had in the last one.
Wait. Sorry, I was just focusing on the visuals and I forgot about that lyric, but is he struggling? What I think I just read and heard, and we'll play it through, so we're going to hear if I'm right on this or not, but I think what I heard is essentially the sentiment of someone who goes, I've kind of built my career on these raw emotions and being deep and like let me hit you in the heart, let me make you cry a little bit, let me make you relate, because, you know, sometimes your life sucks and sometimes my life sucks, and let's talk about that together, let's sit in that, let's be real, let's be authentic. But I think what I might have just picked up on is a little bit of him going, hold up, like, if that's what I'm known for, what if I don't want to put out an emotional song, what if I just want to put out a normal song? That would then be the real version of me, because now I'm in a headspace where I just want to put up a hype song or something like that. But if I don't put up an emotional song, then people will be like, you've changed. But really, the most authentic way to be me is by putting up whatever song is on my heart right now, as opposed to just trying to make it fit for the fans who knew me back then. It's this weird irony, right? Like, it's this, if that's what I think is going on here, that's a really powerful bit of, like, introspective thought. Like my guy is doing some soul searching. Is that the word I'm looking for? And he's gone, man, like, the self-reflection you would need to have to do that is powerful, and something that normally only comes from therapy or really sitting with yourself to figure this out. And if that's the journey he's on at this point, I'm all for it, and all power to him. That's brilliant.
None of y'all are saying, I just sit at the keys, feeling the music. Got me thinking on Beethoven. The game needs a makeover. If you've been waiting, the wait's on.
Also, the keys in Beethoven, which is cool, but also keys is a key, mind the pun, theme throughout this album as well. And again, this guy doesn't do things by accident.
He's feeling the music, got me thinking on Beethoven. The game needs a makeover. If you've been waiting, the wait's over. You ain't noticed y'all about to witness the takeover. They're waiting on me to match the emotion that I had in the last one. What if I don't, they gonna tell me that I'm losing my passion. If I do, am I repeating my actions? Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so the bit of lyric that I did here and read on the screen was tying into exactly that. If I don't pour that emotion in, then they'll tell me, what was it? Here.
Don't tell me that I'm losing my
that I'm losing my passion. But if I do, I'm repeating. I.e., I don't want to be an artist that just is repetitive. I want to grow and further myself. But if I do that, then they're going to say that I've changed. Dude, so many people struggle with this. Like myself, right? I stream on Twitch multiple days a week. And for the last 6-7 years, I've been playing Fortnite. That's been like our main game. But it has crossed my mind where I'm like, what if I don't want to play Fortnite tomorrow? What if you know, I this year want to branch out and, you know, play Pokemon. I obviously love it, as you can see. Or something else. Like, you know, people are going to complain about that potentially and be like, oh, you've changed. You used to do this and host these tournaments and now you play Pokemon or whatever. But at the same time, if I want to be authentic, then that's the way to go. By the way, don't freak out if you are one of our friends on Twitch and all that. Still loving Fortnite and all that kind of stuff. But I'm just saying, it's not outside the realm of possibility to branch out. And that has been on my mind as well recently as I've been assessing and reviewing, you know, the last 6 years and planning for the next 6 years, you know what I mean? And that's really important to do that. Yeah, okay, the masked faces, also therapy session, I believe. I'm sure that piano sitting there is from something. I recall it, but this record wasn't putting out trash. It was disappointing myself in the fan base. Now I want you to picture me. I'm in a hotel rapping, crying on the floor of the bathroom, staring in the mirror of my room. Yeah, that's definitely the kid. That's definitely the kid. And oh, that picture frame, I think that's Mansion, right? Like he's literally got a picture frame of Mansion. Shaking, playing, how could you leave us through the speakers on my iPhone? Reference to How Could You Leave Us. Also, that was super sad. I don't know if you just caught that. He's talking about being in a hotel, and now he's talking about the raw emotion that he still feels from How Could You Leave Us, which, if you don't know, is a song about his mum and his relationship with her, or lack thereof, even. And it's pretty heavy. So for him to reference that like that shows that he's still affected by that at this point, which makes sense. But just bringing that up is pretty powerful. I'm in a hotel rapping, crying on the floor of the bathroom, staring in the mirror of my room, handshaking, playing. How could you leave us through the speakers on my iPhone? Trying to figure out if I'ma always feel the way that I feel, or maybe someday I can learn to be happy, or maybe I can't be. Cause if the music ain't emotional enough, are they gonna call me a has-been? No. But yeah, I get it, dude. That's rough. So exactly what we tapped into earlier, exactly what we assumed, that, you know, the really going, which path do I go down? Like, and all of a sudden he goes, so much of my writing has been about me being unhappy. Do I have to stay unhappy? Because if I become happy, then are people going to say that I've changed or I'm a has-been? Like, That's so deep, man. That's so profound and such a hard scenario to be in. You know what I love? You know what I love? That this is something that most people would wrestle with and journey with, and they would take a break from social media, they would disappear for a while, they would come back and have this clarity, and then they would go from there. This guy brings us along the journey. He literally writes a song about what he's going through, which is so Nate, right? It's so NF to do that. He would write a song about what he's feeling, but he's even writing a song about this transitional period of reflecting and reviewing, and am I even allowed, you know, like all those kinds of things, because what are the fans going to think? Like, it's I love that he lets us journey with him. Like, figure out if I'ma always feel the way that I feel, or maybe someday I can learn to be happy, or maybe I can't be, because if the music ain't emotional enough, are they gonna call me a has-been? Pain's always been the root of my music. If I cut it off, okay. Sitting on the How Could You Leave Us bed. How am I supposed to keep growing? If I let it go, won't my whole career be in ruins? That's when I realize this whole conversation is stupid. I never cared to impress people that don't even know me. I strike what I feel, so I started a movement trying to enjoy a career, but I don't know how to do it when I spend all of my time being afraid I'm gonna lose. But then I figured... Okay. All right, so yes, exactly what we just said. All the, like, man... The doubt comes in, the fear comes in, like everything about this is the kind of music that I would write. And so, like, are people going to leave? Are they going to like it? Are they going to tell me that I'm a has-been, blah, blah, blah. But then he stops and he goes, hold up. This whole thought process is stupid. This whole conversation is stupid because my whole thing is about being real. So the only way for me to be real is to say, stuff that, like, forget what people are going to think or say. I'm going to do me, and I'm going to do it the way that I need to do it. I'm going to be authentic. I'm going to be myself. I'm going to be real and just push on through. And those that are with me are with me, and those that aren't, I don't want them anyway. And, like, it sounds like the way the music just built up. And I heard a couple of notes, I think maybe a key change, I'm not entirely sure, but it definitely sounded like it kind of went a bit more major over minor, if that makes sense. So, i.e., we are getting into a maybe something a little bit more hopeful. I don't know, but it's, I like it. I like it because he's not just telling us about a journey through the song. He's taking us on the journey by painting the picture of the issue and then resolving that potentially.
Rare, but I don't know how to do it when I spend all of my time being afraid I'm gonna lose. But then I figured out the reason they follow me, the reason why these fans surround me. It's not because I'm a rap god, I don't need you people to bow to me. All they ever did was doubt me, now everyone's proud of me. Acknowledge me and not you ain't ignoring the following. I'm
oh, also, he's back. He's back in the plane, by the way. Real? Is that the song that's referenced in that one? And the timing of him walking through the plane in the song Real, if it is from Real, it could be. I might have got the song name wrong. But if it is, then him walking through the plane from Real right as he's talking about being real. And I need to go back. I need to just do this journey one more time.
I don't know how to do it when I spend all of my time being afraid I'm gonna lose. But then I figured out the reason they follow me, the reason why these fans surround me. It's not because I'm a rap god, I don't need you people to bow to me. All they ever did was doubt me, now everyone's proud of me. Acknowledge me and not you ain't ignoring the following. I'm just teaching them something they couldn't learn in colleges. This is for the kids feeling like they live.
Even the chainsaw is there, by the way. If you look carefully, right there, there's a chainsaw. That's part of the video clip.
At the bottom and every day that lies feel like it's darker than Halloween. Yeah, you ain't alone out there, look around.
The uplifting music, I love it. As the strings have come in, it's just, it feels empowering, you know what I mean? Like, oh man. Also, not forgetting about the guy sitting on the floor there. This thing is scattered with Easter eggs and stuff. Like, I feel like I need to rewatch it a few times and then do another, not even a reaction, but a breakdown. You know what I mean? Like, where it's like, give me some time to do my research and let me get back to you, because this thing's wild.
Halloween, I'm just teaching them something they couldn't learn in colleges. This is for the kids feeling like they live at the bottom, and every day their lives feel like it's darker than Halloween. Yeah, you ain't alone out there, look around you, we got a lot of fans in here. Couple hundred thousand, that's what we did last year. Listen to intro 3 trying to kill my fear. Don't get that in a minute, we about to...
I've had goosebumps at numerous points of this song, and that just got me again. Fam, when he released this, intro 3 didn't exist yet. Now, if you remember, intro 3 starts off with him in this conversation with Fear, the persona of Fear, and he's having this dialogue, right? And a lot of you were really impressed in the comments of that video about how I picked up on that. And again, the reason why is because I love, this sounds unrelated, but the Marvel Cinematic Universe, the MCU. There's a YouTube channel called New Rockstars, and a guy named Eric Voss does these breakdowns where he just overanalyzes everything. And I've watched enough of those videos to know what to look at when cinematography focuses in on one item for a little bit too long, or where something just feels a little random, or even if it doesn't. When I watch a video, I don't look in the center of the screen. I'm looking far left, far right. I'm looking everywhere to spot whatever I need to spot and put it together like a puzzle. It's why I loved English once upon a time. Like when I was in school, I mean, like the class English. Is that a thing everywhere around the world? I don't know. We had an English class. Maybe you did too. Maybe you had a Vietnamese class. I don't know. Let me know. But nonetheless, in English, I loved doing that kind of stuff because I was good at analyzing things and breaking it down. And that's now carried into this series. But here he mentions intro 3 and then he says, you'll get that soon or something like that. Like, you'll get that in a minute. I don't remember the wording. I only heard it once. But like, That's brilliant. Also, the feeling of like camaraderie that you get from him saying, hey, the real fans are here with me, but don't worry, you're not alone. Like, we're all in this together. Like, he makes all the fans kind of feel like they've got this connection with each other as well. Dude, if his concerts have that vibe, I'm gonna like actual cry real tears, because that's crazy. We're doing this again. This is going to be a longer video, but I don't even care. This thing is deep and amazing, and I hope you're enjoying it too. Let's keep going.
The kids feeling like they live at the bottom, and every day their lives feel like it's darker than Halloween. Yeah, you ain't alone out there. Look around you, we got a lot of fans in here. Couple hundred thousand, that's what we did last year. Listen to intro 3 trying to kill my fear. Don't get that in a minute. We about to shatter the critics. I am a savage, admit it. A lot of baggage I live in. That's why the passion is different. Really don't care if they get it. We're only 3 records in it, and this is just the beginning. I'm home.
We're only 3 records in, and this is just the beginning. Like this on warm-up that we just did. That's so powerful, dude. Everything about this just hits. What's he picking up? The keys! The keys from Outkast, the keys that are referenced in so many things. In fact, is it this album? Correct me if I'm wrong. Is it this album that the cover art is the jail cell? Is that this album? We've been in this album for a while, so it's hard for me to remember all the details. But, like, yeah, the keys have been a huge theme through multiple songs throughout this. And, ladies and gentlemen, what an adventure it has been. If you have enjoyed going on this journey with me as we now tick that box of another album and then start the journey in 2024 into our next album, please subscribe and turn on notifications so when we upload the next one, you will not miss it. If you've enjoyed going on Nate's journey, then perhaps you might enjoy journeying with me as we go through this. And I'm being very intentional to not pre-listen to any of the other songs or anything. Like, my wife has been wanting to put stuff on, and as soon as she does, or if she says she wants to, I'm just like, nah. And we literally hit skip track and we just go, nah. As best we can, we are keeping all of it for you guys, for our YouTube family. So thank you for being here. Thank you for hanging out. It's been an absolute pleasure. God bless you guys. God loves you guys. And so do I. I hope you enjoyed it. And as always, my friends, okay, love you. Bye. I'll see you in the next one.